Christmas, Happy New Year. We still should be going through the 12 days of Christmas. I know it's past Christmas Day already, but it's still technically the 12 days of Christmas. And today I'm doing the last of the three that my buddy Wayne from Bucks County Beer Reviews sent me. Check out his channel on YouTube. I will leave a link up here and a link in the description below. Thank you again, Wayne. These have been so awesome. And this is the one, the last but not least, that I've been saving. The Mad Elf. Handcrafted by the Trogues Brothers. Trogues Independent Brewing. Nice. So, 11% ABV. Wow. From the Trogues Brewing Company, which is in Hershey, Pennsylvania. You know what else is in Hershey, Pennsylvania? I ain't gotta even say it, you should know. Wow. Once a year. Brewed with Pennsylvania wildflower honey. Now it's telling me to serve in a chalice, which I will do. Instead of over there, I will serve it. And this. Okay, it's time. The Mad Elf is here with a nuanced blend of sweet and tart cherries, Pennsylvania honey, chocolate malt, and a hint of mischief. The essence of this legendary holiday ale, along with its ruby red glow, is born from five varieties of tree-ripened cherries. Local wildflower honey sweetens the celebration, and a spicy Belgian yeast adds subtle notes of cinnamon, clove, and allspice. It's not the holidays until you've had your first Mad Elf. That's nice. That's a nice claim there. Yeah, it's pretty much what it says on here. And I believe they named the cherries. Don't they name them on here too? Bing Lambert Van. That's the type. You got Bing cherries, Lambert cherries, Van cherries, Royal Anne cherries, and Montmorency. Yeah, Montmorency cherries. And they use chocolate grain, chocolate malts, Munich malts, Pilsner malts. Nice. They don't have anything as far as yeast. They use a spicy Belgian yeast. They don't have anything listed down as far as hops, so. All right. I don't think you need hops with everything else they got in here, right? Ooh. I'm getting a little note of cherry right on the nose. It's not like real pungent, but. I don't think I'm going to be able to get a nip of the head in this thing. Nah, not even worried about it. That's one downside to these glasses. Now it's, you know, hard to do that. But it's perfect for taking a look. Look at that elf. He definitely looks mad, doesn't he? Looks like he's mad with alcohol rage. Definitely looking messed up. Alright, it's already dark outside, so it can't use natural light. Hoo-hoo, but just look at that. Look at the way that just lit up. There's, without the light. Boom! Nice. So, kind of cloudy. But not very cloudy. Not as cloudy as one would think. Very nice. It's a beautiful beer, if I do say so myself. Nice, yeah. This glass doesn't do well on the top. All right. Color-wise, darker than I thought. I'm thinking about a 22, maybe a little darker, 25. All right, I'm excited about this. It's time to drink it. Alright, I'm excited now. Oh, way more aromatic out of the can. I'm smelling cherry, malt, chocolate. Nice. Salute. And salute, Wayne. Merry Christmas. Salute and happy days. Oh, wow. That's pretty damn good. That is divine. I like that. You get the cherry. It's medium to full in the body. It's not dry. Man. Nice little tartness to it. Taste the cherry, taste the chocolate notes. There's some other stuff in there. What else did they nail? I don't know. There's a lot of flavors going on here. Maybe some fig. I want to say a little bit of orange. Like oranges, cherries, figs. Wow. That is really fantastic. It's 11%, so that's in the back end too, but actually this is, they hide that 11% pretty damn well. I mean, it's there, but I've had less percentage beers. Actually, one of the ones that he gave me, if I'm mistaken, it was the first one, the not the COB, but the one before that, I think even had more of a booziness to it than this sucker at 11%. Wow. Fantastic. And food-wise with this, I'd pair this with a nice, good honey glazed ham. Would be the best thing, I think, for sure. So I messed up. I'm getting my order out of whack here. But anyways, this beer on Beer Advocate gets an 87 out of 100 with an average of 3.88 with 4,260 reviews. On Untappd with over 160.1,000 reviews, it gets a 3.83. That's pretty good. I like this one. I don't care what it even costs. I'd like to get this every year. I wouldn't keep it in stock, something like that. But I would definitely get it again, no matter what, just as a treat. I mean, unless that was like $12 for that 12-ounce can, then maybe I wouldn't. But I don't see it being that much. God bless it. I hope it wouldn't be. But I like it a lot. This is something special. You know, this has got the craveability. It's got the craveability to it. And I think it will ring the memory bells, you know. I like this one. It's a solid Big B beer review grade, A+. It's an A+. It's a damn fine beer. I like this one for sure. And I would highly recommend it. If y'all have had this beer, let me know in the comments below what you guys think about the Mad Elf. Wayne, thank you again so much. You are the man. Words just can't describe it, man. You are my true beer best friend right there. You are the beer man. Y'all make sure you check out Bucks County Beer Reviews. Thanks to the shirt. Thanks to the beers, Wayne. It's been awesome. That is super cool. And I hope y'all have been enjoying watching this as much as I definitely am enjoying drinking this one. If so, hit that like button. And stay tuned. I got plenty more good stuff coming. And to make sure you don't miss out, hit that subscribe button. It doesn't cost anything. And hit that little notification bell. And I hope to catch y'all here again next time. Till then, salute. Happy days. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Salute.